pray our 2 rak'ah or 4 rak'ah. Barely. And now Ramadan is telling you, hey, you have more time for this. Suddenly it's proven to you. You can come for Fajr. It was so hard just a few days ago, right? I wonder how it's going to look like a few days after Ramadan. It's going to get hard again all of a sudden, subhanAllah. It was so hard for us to come for Isha, and now we're staying an hour, 2 hours after Isha. Doing what? Conversing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, salah. Many people that come to the imam and they say, Ya Shaykh, I've been praying for 10 years, 15 years, 5 years. I just don't feel it. And I thought salah is supposed to be communication with Allah Azza wa Jalla. The answer is easy to me. Even though every single night we're coming to pray Taraweeh, it doesn't seem for many people to connect. Like, I don't feel it. What am I missing? Wudu, I did perfect wudu, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. I dressed up nicely for it. And I put utar, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. I made sure to be early in the masjid. I'm trying my best. But what is it that I'm missing in my salah that is not helping me feel it? It's easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Successful are the believers. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Those when they pray with khushu, which means focus and concentration. So what is it that we're missing from our salah, jama'ah? Is it the communication part? No. We communicate with Allah Azza wa Jalla. We're missing from something else called connection. What does it mean? You see, the internet, if you have Wi-Fi at home, and you open your laptop or iPad, and you see the full bar, doesn't mean you have internet? Doesn't mean you have internet. You only have communication with a router. If you didn't pay the bill, the cable company, you won't have internet. Just because you're communicating doesn't mean you're connecting. And Allah says here, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Successful are the believers, those who when they pray, they connect. He didn't say those who pray. It's already implied. They're believers. Allah says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Successful are the believers. So it's already implied that they should pray. But what is wrong with their salah? They pray, but they don't connect in the salah. We come to Salat al-Taraweeh, our mind is busy when the imam is going to finish. We stand in salah and we're just waiting, am I going to be able to go back before, you know, this and such show, you know, end or start? I'm here in Taraweeh and I'm just like, I don't know, should I stay for 8 or 4? So there is less and less focus on benefiting from the salah than actually connecting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our salah. How can I connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? By the way, just a plug in between a husband and wife. That's the same problem you have with your spouse all the time. You guys talk, but you don't connect. You only communicate. But you don't communicate in a language that is understood to your spouse. You say, I've done my part. Yeah, but not the way they understand. Similarly, when you pray, you say, I did my part. But yeah, not in the way that is pleasing, probably perfectly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to make it more perfect. The connection need to be perfect. How can I make that connection perfect in salah, inshallah? We still have, alhamdulillah, 3 quarters of Ramadan. And I want you to focus on your salah so that you concentrate, you have khushu', and bi'idhnillah, connect with Allah Azza wa Jalla so that you benefit the best way in your salah. Of course, obviously, subhanAllah, those who have been blessed at the same time, tested and tried to speak the Arabic language, understand the Arabic language, are those who have the greatest amana. The greatest amana to connect with Allah Azza wa Jalla. You understand Arabic? You've been tested. Wallahi, it's so serious test. SubhanAllah, I was standing there and just listening to the recitation of Surah Al-An'am, and I'm just like, SubhanAllah, every single ayah is a khatra by itself. Every single ayah have a meaning that just like, and it just hit me again, I'm just like, subhanAllah, probably I'm one of the few people in this entire congregation who understand what the imam is reciting. And wallahi, I got scared, suddenly I just had that shiver in my body. Just the thought itself, among the few who's understanding what the imam is reciting, is as scary. I had that first experience when I was in Bosnia. First time ever living outside of the Arab world, I went to Bosnia there, and I was praying Salat Taraweeh in our local masjid. The Imam, the half was local Imam, barely speaks Arabic. As I was, alhamdulillah, in Salah behind the Imam, and then the Imam recited something. It was very, of course, obviously very profound in that moment in time for me. So without even paying attention, I nodded my head. After Salah, the gentleman next to me, an older man, he's in his 60s, one of my students as well, subhanAllah, was teaching him Arabic. He tells me, he goes, why did you nod your head in salam? I said, did I do that? I didn't pay attention. He goes, yeah, you did. I said, what was it for? I said, honestly, I don't know, I don't remember, but I think it's because the Imam recited something was very profound. So as I was speaking, he goes, what? He goes, what did you just say? So, well, the Imam recited something very profound. I said, do you want to tell me that you understand what the Imam recites? And I'm like, well, sometimes I need tafsir. He goes, no. Just the Imam, what he recites. Do you really understand that? And I'm like, alhamdulillah. He broke in tears. He started weeping. Not just crying, wallahi, he started weeping. And I'm just like, what did I do to him? So I put my arm over his shoulder. I'm just like, it's all right, it's okay, what's going on? What's happening? He goes, subhanAllah, he says, when is that day going to come for me to understand the Quran the way you do? Wallahi, that moment in time was my first moment to realize the blessing of understanding Arabic. I've never thought this to be such a great blessing until that moment for me. Just that you hear the Imam reciting and you're just enjoying it. I had more responsibility, more than anybody probably here, to focus on what the Imam is reciting, to understand, to have that for sure. So my responsibility is greater. And I would like to convey this responsibility to each and every one of you. You don't understand Arabic? That's fine. Learn keywords. Make an effort. Go online, find keywords, Quranic keywords. There are a few hundred words, not too many really. If every single night you would remember three, four words every night throughout Ramadan, you will be able to understand more than a quarter, not even a third of the Quran. General words such as Rabbu Samawati wal Ard. Most of us know that. The Lord of the heavens and the earth. Musa, Fir'aun. You hear these names, you know who they are. You know a story about Musa and Fir'aun. All of that. Then few keywords will help you, inshallah, connect with the Quran. Whatever the Imam is reciting, you can make the story based on the word that you're hearing and listening to. You hear the word Jannah, Jahannam, Rahman, Rahim. You know what Allah talks to you, speak about, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Connect with the Quran. Don't just let your mind start getting distracted, going all over the place because you don't understand Arabic. That's not an excuse. Find key words where you can connect with. You want to make it better even? Alhamdulillah, they will announce for you what the Imam is reciting tomorrow. You know what the Imam is reciting next day. Before you come over here, if you understand Arabic, read tafsir. If you don't understand Arabic, read translation. Read it. Know exactly what the context is. So when you come behind the Imam, you know the few key words that you can tell, oh, so this is what he is reciting right now. You can connect with the Book of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Fine, you don't have time for this, you don't have the energy for that. The least you could enjoy is just the melodies of the recitation. Just the sound of it is ni'mah. Wallahi, just listen to the sound of the Quran is a blessing. And I've tried that with a lot of my non-Muslim friends. One time there was a person coming to work, something in the house, and I made deliberately the Quran playing, you know, while he's working in the house. And left him. After a few minutes I came back again. The first thing he asked me, he goes, what is this? I'm like, what do you mean? He goes, this thing that's playing, what is that? And I'm like, why? He goes, oh my God, it's so soothing. How come it's so good? He goes, what is that? I said, that's the Quran. He goes, wow. Wallahi, he was just a plumber working something in the kitchen. And for him, I said, do you want a copy of this? He goes, yeah, please. That was that back in the day when CDs was something actually that you could give to people. So I gave him a copy, I said, here you go, take it. And I just made dua from Allah, guide his heart, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Another time I was actually working in an office and I had the Quran playing as I was subhanAllah there. A person from the other side of the office came to my office room and he asked me, he said, what is that you're playing? I said, that's Quran. He goes, wow, this is how beautiful it is. He said, yeah. He goes, can I have a copy? I said, sure. I gave him a copy. Wallah, a few days back he comes back, he goes, can I have more copies? I've been in my office, my friends want copies too. Even non-Muslims, when they just hear the Quran, it has its own power. It's not the power of the CD itself, it's not the power of the reciter himself, it's the power of the words of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So whether you know the Arabic language or not, whether you're going to make an effort to read the translation or not, or learn a few words or not, whether you have that or not in you, the least you could do is just listen, focus, and enjoy the recitation. Remember, it's not about communicating only, it's about connection. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who listen to the speech and follow the best of the Ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our hearts to Islam and fill it with Iman, Ya Rabbil Alameen. May ask Allah Azza to make us among those who listen to the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal and connect with it perfectly, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.